Pay attention to that the prerequisite for completing this step is to ensure that the device is online. On this interface, click Application Management. On the pop-up interface, enter the name of application and application description. You can enter any values. Select status of application as public. You can ignore add logo. Click create. Click the device we just created. Click edit on the upper right corner to enter the edit interface. Drag the switch, rotary knob, and the dashboard to proper place. Click on the switch in the property bar on the right. Select data stream, this device, and then click the value of the switch. Move to the bottom of the content of EDP command. Enter switch on the input box. Then click the rotary knob on the interface. Click data stream, select this device. Click the value, move to the bottom of the content of EDP command. Enter switch on the input box. Then just click on the dashboard and change to WD of the input box above the property bar. Click select the data stream on property bar, select this device. Choose WD in the data stream. Click another dashboard and change to SD of the input box above the property bar. Click select the data stream on property bar, select this device. Choose SD in the data stream, and then click to save. Back to the interface, refresh. Click on, the LED on Arduino is on. Indicates that the experiment is successful. This is the effect. You see when we click off, the LED of P13 of Arduino will be off. Click on, the LED will be on. Rotate the knob. The digital tube will display the value of the rotary knob. This is all for the experiment. In the next tutorial, we'll show you the code implementation process.